Honorable Amadi Ogunwa Dennis, member representing Nuji, Ezeagu Federal Constituency of Enugu State. Mr. Speaker, I want to use this opportunity to thank the mover of this motion. And just as we've been saying in this parliament, this motion is also a reiteration of how we'll be shortchanged as a nation. When you take the instance of an oil swap, whereby our crude are swapped with finished products overseas, we find out today that crude is average over $52. And we have nothing to show that the international price of crude have gone down on the value of the product that is being imported into the country. We cannot continue as a nation, Mr. Speaker, by building all costs that will inflict on the pockets of the citizens. When you look at the issues being highlighted, you discover that a savings of 70 naira or more than that on a litre translates a turnover of over 10 trillion in a year. That is why you see the man from Maiduguri who is trading on his cow will sell an average cow at 200,000 to a consumer. That is how the woman selling tomatoes will increase his price to average of 500 naira for about 3 or 4 pieces. That is the suffering in the street. Mr. Speaker, the mover of the motion calling for ad hoc investigation, the PPR have not acted as an agency of government where the plight of Nigerians are taken into consideration in bringing up these templates. We cannot have a template that is expensive than the template existing somewhere across Benin Republic. If we begin to flow on issues that have been highlighted by the previous speakers, we may not live here. But I think what we need to do as a parliament is to set up investigation that will involve both the NNPC that have taken majority of the franchise on bringing these products into the country. The independent marketers that are selling the products, who by in one way or the other are also the owners of the jetty where these products are being discharged. When you factor a cost that is existing from year to year and is not variable in line with the national economy, not in line with the recession we are suffering, I think people need to answer a call on what is happening to Nigeria. Not when people come here, they pretend as if all is well. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, I encourage the move of the motion and certainly plead with my colleagues to support this motion. And let's take every bit iota of seriousness to ensure that the investigation is carried out to the letter. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.